Just had a bad dream, that's all.
Dream? It sounds more like you had a nightmare. What was it about?
Never mind, it was just a dream.
I love you, Paul.
I love you, Anne.
I just woke up a moment ago and had to call you. You haven't forgotten about today, have you?
Let's see. Oh, yes. We're getting married today, aren't we?
Do you, Paul, this woman for your lawful wedded wife? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love, honor, and cherish her, and that forsaking all others for her alone, that you will perform upon her all the duties that a husband owes to his wife for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you, Anne, take this man for your lawful wedded husband? And do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love, honor, and cherish him, and that forsaking all others for him alone, that you will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
You will now place the ring upon Anne's left hand and repeat after me. This ring I give thee.
This ring I give thee.
In token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love.
In token and in pledge of our constant faith and abiding love.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Inasmuch as Paul and Anne have consented together in holy wedlock and witnessed the same before God in this company, and have thereto given and pledged their faith each to the other, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. And now, may the God of all righteousness bless, preserve, and keep you till death.
No one else.
see the sun of those who go in search of heaven. Watch over the ones who've only begun. Take my hand, take my heart, and I will be yours till death do us part. My gift is my love, forever and always, to have and hold. As long as you live, until time is gone, and dust is my prison, all the love in my heart to you I will give. Take my hand, take my heart, and I will be yours till death do us part.
Hello, sleepyhead.
Hello, darling. Are we there yet?
No, not yet. I just pulled over so we wouldn't run off the road in this fog.
Where are we?
I haven't the foggiest.
Why haven't you the foggiest?
Because I'm sleepy.
Oh, you poor darling. You must be exhausted. Been driving for hours. What time is it?
About 3 a.m. We're running a little behind schedule, aren't we?
I was just thinking of when we're grandparents and our grandchildren ask us where we spent our honeymoon. I'll say, oh, we just parked by the side of a deserted road.
Say, you're really planning ahead.
Oh, yes. We're going to be together a long time, darling. Forever. I'm never going to let you go.
I hadn't exactly planned on leaving. You know, it's taken me long enough to get you.
I wanted to marry you since I first saw you at the country club. But I thought you'd think I was too aggressive if I showed it. So I tried to be very cool and detached.
I know, but you didn't fool me a bit. I could see right through you.
No.
Mm-hmm.
No. How could you?
I have my ways.
Well, it really doesn't matter now that we're safely married, does it? I still can't believe it yet. I'm a married woman. What time is it? We've been married nearly 14 hours.
Nearly 11.
Oh, well, never mind. I still don't feel any different.
Well, maybe that's because we really haven't started our married life yet. You'll feel different in a little while.
Oh, I wish this fog would lift so we could get moving.
Well, I've heard that sometimes these coastal fogs sock in for days. They get so thick you can't even tell night from day.
Oh, no. What do we do?
Well, as long as we've stopped and we've got nothing better to do, why don't you come on over and let me love you a little bit?
Well, I guess I might as well. Seeing as there's nothing else to do.
Did you hear something?
No. What is it?
Didn't you hear that?
No.
Look. Out there in the mist.
What is it?
What
do you see? Paul, where are you going? Paul? Paul, what happened?
Not sure. I thought I saw something, but there was nothing there. I almost fell off the edge. I must be so tired, my imagination's playing tricks on me.
Poor darling. You look exhausted. Why don't you come over here and relax? Until the fog lifts. Come on. Come on, lie down. Just relax. That's right. Now relax. Close your eyes. That's right. Relax and try and go to sleep. Paul?
Mm-hmm.
You're not sorry, are you?
Mm-hmm.
What?
About you? Never.
I can't help it. I just want to be sure that you really love me. Oh, I love you so. You won't be sorry. Ever change the way we are now? Does this sound silly?
No. Not really.
You don't have to humor me. No, I'm being silly. I could just always be like this. Until we die. Sorry, I didn't mean to sound morbid. I mean, it's like I'm on the threshold of a tremendous new experience.
You are, darling. We're starting our new life tomorrow. I mean, today. Remember, Mrs. Ryan? Lifting. Come on. Let's hurry.
don't you think you better turn on the light?
What would I do without it?
Don't worry about her. No, she's already dead. Come on.
What a shame, Sergeant. She was beautiful. There wasn't a mark on her. It was like she was asleep.
Yeah, well, what are you going to do about it?
Come on,
you
back.
Find any ID on her?
Yeah, we found a purse. There was a driver's license by the name of Ann Marston.
He's fairly well recovered physically. It's his psychological condition.
Tell me about him again.
Emergency brought him and his wife in several months ago. Auto accident. He was in pretty bad shape. Multiple contusions, compound comminuted fracture of the tibia. She was dead. It was an accident. But for some reason, he felt responsible for her death. He was so agitated for a while, we had to keep him sedated.
How long has this depressed condition been evident?
Well, I can't say exactly. But I would estimate soon after he got out of traction. Lately, he's been getting worse. He's even been acting as if his wife was still alive. That's what really disturbs me.
Why don't we head back to my office? I'd like to go through the medical reports again.
Fine, I'd appreciate that.
Thing to remember in cases of reactive depression is that there could be a spontaneous remission. A recovery could be initiated by a very common occurrence, such as coming into contact with another person or having a change of environment. How does his family feel about the situation?
Very concerned. Anne will do all they can to help.
You know, the tragedy is that they are both so young. They're just beginning life together.
Yeah.
Put yourself in his place. Just imagine that your bride was killed on a wedding night. That would have a traumatic effect on anyone. Well, then how are we to determine if his behavior is so abnormal? Or to what extent his depression is pathologically protracted? Fortunately, not too many of us ever face such tragedy in our life.
Well, when you look at it that way, I can see where it would have a lasting effect. But I still got an uneasy feeling. Call it a hunch, gut reaction, whatever.
I'm concerned, too. But when you look into his background, you find there's good ego strength, personality integration. Perhaps if we got him out of this hospital environment and back to work, especially if we could get his family's assistance.
That might help a lot.
Well, then why don't I talk to his family and make arrangements? You talk to him. Tell him a little something of what we have in mind.
Good idea.
You may not agree with me now, but you must get your life moving forward again. Believe me, Paul, in time, you will get over it. Don't you want to go home? Is that it? Is there some other place you'd rather go instead?
No.
All right, then, Paul. I'll be talking to you soon.
There is a place.
Wait! Wait!
Listen, Doctor, I've been thinking, and
maybe you're right.
How soon could I leave?
Well, we'll have to make the arrangements. Then as soon as your family can come down to pick you up.
Oh, that's a lot of trouble for them, Doctor. Why don't I just give them a call when I get to the airport?
I don't know, I'd feel a lot better if...
Now, listen, you said yourself I was completely well except for my leg.
Yeah? So why not? Don't worry, Doctor. Everything's gonna be fine. I'll go get back.
Passing away is part of the scheme of things, Mr. Ryan. Who are we to say? Life is death. Death is life. But sometimes, when one is so young... Ah, yes. I remember the young lady very well. So peaceful in repose. She might have been asleep. You will be happy to know that we here at Eden Glen have been taking very good care of her, as we do all our guests. Our accommodations are among the very best.
I understand all of that, Mr. Hilton. But all I want to know is where she is buried so that I can go there.
Oh, yes. Well, I believe she's residing near Serenity Boulevard. Let me see. Oh, yes. Here she is, Mr. Ryan. Yes, I was right. On Serenity Boulevard, Eternity Crypt, Row 1, Number 7, North Wall. That's one of our nicest sections. Some of our very best people reside there. You see, Mrs. Wilton Pettigrew is nearby, and also our former mayor. Oh, she's with very good company, and... Well, let me see. Oh, dear, it is rather late. Ordinarily, I'd say come back tomorrow. But since your journey has been far, it would be a pity to disappoint you.
You're right. I'd feel very disappointed.
I understand. However, it is rather difficult to find the vault, for a stranger, that is. Well, here. I will escort you personally. After you, sir. This way, please. You see, Mr. Ryan, how beautiful and lovingly tended our grounds are. We consider a quiet, peaceful atmosphere essential to the spiritual well-being of our guests. Oh, Mr. Ryan, look over there to your right. They're just concluding an interment. Such a beautiful sight never fails to move me. The bidding of farewell to the temporal existence by the friends of the deceased. The mound of freshly turned earth, symbolizing the return to the bosom of Mother Earth, from whence we all sprang. Have you ever given it much thought, Mr. Ryan?
Not much.
Oh, pity. You should. You never know. You know, for one who plans ahead, our funeral security program will offer...
Look, it's getting very late. May we talk about this some other time?
Oh, forgive me. I get carried away. Oh, Mr. Ryan, over there. See our new patio garden memorial?
Yes.
They offer a source of untold comfort to the bereaved. Oh, here. We're almost to Serenity Boulevard now. Incidentally, just over that hill, we have our new crematorium, right on the grounds. Isn't that convenient? Oh, I just thought I'd mention it in case you might be interested. In Mrs. Ryan's case, I should point out that although interment was almost immediate, we handled her body with loving care.
You handled?
Yes, sir. Oh, strictly in accordance with the instructions of the deceased family. Sir, we're almost at her final resting place now. I must apologize for this disorder, Mr. Ryan. This is most unusual. The workmen you get today. Well, I'll go inside and speak to them at once. Excuse me, please. There we are, all neat and tidy again. Oh, yes, please remember that we close in exactly 36 minutes.
Let's split. It's going to rain soon. Hey, hold it, will you? We've got to check to see that everybody's out. Besides, we've got to get our tools.
Oh, man, you're making enough noise. Even the stiffs are going to hear you. And would you quit worrying about the tools, okay? There ain't nobody down there that's going to hurt them none. Let's go. It's starting to rain already. I'm not getting paid to get wet. Come on.
At least let me lock up.
Okay, lock up.
Anybody out there? Help! Let me out of here! I'm locked in! I'm locked in! Help me! I'm over here! I'm locked in! I'm out of here! Damn it! Help me! I'm locked in! I'm over here!
Thank you. You hear me? This is Paul. Don't you know me? You're safe now.
Paul?
Yes. It's me. Life. I thought I'd lost you. All that time without you. How many times I wanted to die.
Oh, it was horrible. I was asleep, but yet I wasn't. I remember the lights. And then going off the road. And then waking up, suffocating.
It's over now. I'll try to forget. You're with me. And we'll never be parted again. Ever. Something to wrap you up in.
There. That's better now, isn't it? See, you've been inactive for so long, your muscles have stiffened. Metabolism slowed down to practically nothing, I guess. I've heard of cases where the metabolism has become so slow, the needs of the body are practically nil. To all outward appearances, the person is dead.
I still don't understand.
I don't either, really. All I know is that this is a miracle. Divine miracle.
Yes? Where are you? There you are, Apple. Oh.
You act as if you'd seen that cat before.
Oh, yes. We're friends, aren't we?
I don't remember you ever having a cat. In fact, I'm not so sure you even liked cats before.
Why are you questioning me like this?
I'm sorry, Ann. I didn't mean it that way. Listen, you need some warm food and proper medical care. Can't get out of here till morning. What are we sitting here in the dark for? I saw some candles when I first came in. We have light.
Would it be too much to hope for a fireplace, too?
Oh, I've missed you. You bet I'll find a fireplace. I'll find anything else you want to. In fact, I'll look hard enough. I might even find a way out of here. Thank you.
we're stuck here for the night.
Oh,
well, darling, we'll get out. Just a matter of waiting a few hours, that's all.
Maybe we're not meant to get out.
Hush, hush. In a few hours, it'll be daylight. Workmen will be back and we'll be free. Okay? Good. Now, I say, let's brighten this place up a little bit. Those candles look big enough to do the job. If not, there's more inside. Don't go away. I'll be right back. Hey, these look pretty old. Must have been here for a long time.
It's all right.
Don't worry, that gate's electrified.
Oh, your mortal life is in danger.
Why, that's
I'm
nonsense.
Afraid for you.
That's nonsense. Now, you wait here. I'll go light the candles.
Don't leave me.
All right. Come on, then.
There, you see? We'll be all right.
Come on. Why don't we make ourselves comfortable?
Maybe we better not. Abaddon.
And relax. Everything will be fine.
But
you don't think I'm going to let some stupid cat bother me, do you? Come here. Come on. Now listen. You just think about what we're going to do when we get out of here. We're going to forget all about this place. We're going to have fun and enjoy life. Don't interrupt. First, I'm going to take you to a place where there's sunshine every day and warm water. And beaches, okay?
Yes.
After we've soaked up enough sun, we'll fly to London. Got some relatives over there I haven't seen in a long time. Oh, they're gonna love you. And we can catch up on life in the big city. How does that sound so far?
Oh, it sounds wonderful, Paul.
Good, that's my girl.
I want to live again. Be with people. Be where it's bright.
Okay, after we've flown the...
That won't stop them. They'll never let us go.
They?
Yes. We're doomed, you and I.
No. Nothing's changed. It'll be just like I said, you wait and see. Look, kid. It's just a stupid cat.
It must have gone crazy or something, and now it's dead. That can't hurt us, can it?
Oh, can it? Look at it, Ann. Can that hurt us? Answer me!
Oh, Paul, you just don't understand.
What's to understand? I've given you a very logical explanation. It just went crazy. It's just a cat. A poor, dumb animal. Now, what else is there? There's a logical explanation. There has to be. Otherwise... I'm all right. I'm just tired. Shaky, I guess. My doctor says I'm supposed to take it easy for a while. Why don't we?
What's the matter, darling?
Nothing.
I had missed you so much. But I never realized what sweet torment it would be to find you again.
I don't understand.
We were worlds apart, but in the twinkling of eternity, through the brightness of our love, we were brought together again. And now, very shortly, I must go back.
Oh, Anne, don't even think that. We'll have the rest of our lives together.
Oh, Paul, can't you see? Look around you, the stillness. It's like we were suspended somewhere in eternity between time and space and heaven and earth. In our own world, where our spirits have merged briefly. No past, no future, no other people, just us here now.
Yes. I feel it too.
I know. It's beautiful, isn't it? In a moment, it'll all be over. And you can forget the body. My spirit reaches out towards your spirit. There's nothing to be afraid of, darling. It's merely a passing over and you're free at last. Don't you see? If you can just open your heart to the body of life, you can behold the spirit of death. It's timeless. It's beautiful. Life and death are all one, like the river and the sea are one.
Never talked this way before. What's the matter with you?
Just believe me, darling, and accept. We can go on forever like this.
No, Anne.
Oh, Paul. Paul, don't leave me again. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Oh, kiss me. Kiss me. Oh. Oh, I love you so much.
Sorry, Anne. I can't. Not here.
No, Paul. Do it, please. Please do it now. Love me. I want to feel your life inside of me.
Oh, Anne. Can't you see? Anne, please stop.
Oh, please, Paul.
This is madness. We've got to get out of here. Do you understand what I'm saying? Please.
I'm sorry. I can't help. I didn't want to lose you again. And I know I'll never get out of here. I belong here.
Look. Look, it's almost dawn. See, the sun will be up soon. And you'll be all right once we get out of here. Darling, hold on just a little longer. For me, please. Please.
I'll try.
What's the matter?
Never leave this place. I know it now. You must forget me.
Never. You're my whole life. Don't you know that? What is it?
Did you see? The candle, it went out. They came and put it out.
What are you talking about? Will you please stop?
No, it's true.
Damn it, will you stop? Look, look, it's almost dawn. We'll be out of here soon.
No, never. I told you I'll never leave here. Can't you see that? Get away from me. I'm one of them now.
Listen to me, Anne.
Look, look, can't you see? There goes another one. They're all around us now. We can't stop them. They've come for me. They're not going to let me go.
You know you're imagining this. Now you have me imagining it too. But there's a logical explanation. And I'm going to show you.
No, don't go there.
I've got to show you that what you're saying is nonsense. That this is a perfectly natural phenomenon.
the moisture. An excessive accumulation of moisture. Probably due to the fog. Don't forget, we had a heavy rainstorm last night, too.
Paul! Look out! They're coming closer!
Oh, can't be it. It's not that way at all. You'll see. Wipe it off. Just the dampness. Wipe it off and show you it's...
That gate. Be careful. All right, let's clear this gate out. Okay, go ahead.
Hey, man. Take a look over here.
Oh, my God.
was here last night. We locked him inside. I don't understand why he didn't hear us when we called. We did call, didn't we?
It's another one.
My gift is my love, forever and always, to have and to hold, for as long as you live, until time is gone. Dust is my prison, all the love of my heart to you I will give. Take my